Hi, my name's Paul, and this is my good friend Andrew.
And welcome to Two Guys and Guitars.
So Andrew, I had a pretty rough day yesterday. I accidentally stood on a grape, and it gave out a little whine.
So for the first Two Guys and Guitars lesson, we wanted to go with the minor pentatonic scale, and more specifically, the first shape of the minor pentatonic scale. The minor pentatonic scale is a minor scale, obviously, and it's made up of five notes. The Latin word pent, standing for sonspitchen of every.
Yeah, I mean, come on, let's be honest. The pentatonic scale is the best thing ever created known to man ever. Because straight away, I remember the first time I learned this minor pentatonic scale, you know, first shape, I was writing a riff a day, I think, probably, and soloing, you know, and then you just, it's that thing as you work more with it, you realise it's used for, like, everything, all your favourite riffs, all your favourite songs, songwriting, soloing.
Yeah, it's very much the gateway to improvisation. Not only being able to play along with the songs you already know, I remember, you know, playing along with Along to Records and stuff like that, but also being able to, you know, have a relationship with other musicians and actually be able to improvise with people, jam with people. It's kind of very much a good communication tool. And like we say, it does, the simplicity of it being the five notes means it really does more or less sound great over everything. I mean, even, you know, the further up you go with your playing, there's still loads of different exciting ways to use it. And I know for all you players out there, you know, all the pentatonic scale, there's always still, I'm still finding out stuff all the time that I never knew with it, and there's lots of different exciting avenues to go with it. So
let's get to the lesson plan.
So for us guitar players, the minor pentatonic scale is broken up into five different shapes. Each shape starts on a different note of the pentatonic scale, and each shape follows the other sequentially.
So today we're obviously going to be looking at shape number one, pentatonic scale. So this is really important, isn't it? Because, you know, it's the groundwork and foundations of all of the other pentatonic scales. So everything we're going to learn in this, all the fingers and everything like that, is very important. Let's take a look at it. Okay, cool. So let's take a look at this first shape of the pentatonic scale. So the first important concept to grasp is wherever we're going to place our first finger on the sixth string is actually going to be the root of the scale. So for example, in this case, we're actually on the fifth fret, which is an A. So it's actually going to be the A minor pentatonic scale. So check this out. So we've got fifth fret on the sixth string, eighth fret. Then on the next one, we got 5, 7, then the next one, 5, 7. On the third string, it's the exact same again. So 5, 7, second string, 5, 8, and then just on the first string, 5, 8. So just to recap, 5, 8, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5, 8, then 5, 8.
What area code is that?
I think Uzbekistan.
Okay. So again, take real strong note of the fingers he was using there. The point being is that especially with practicing scales and really developing your technique, you know, making sure that you're practicing stuff correctly from the very start is really the key to kind of making sure that whatever you're playing, you can do it as kind of economically as possible. It's definitely the case when you're trying to build up licks and work on especially speed, is really making sure that you're not getting kind of the equivalent of tongue-tied on your fingers. So now we're going to start looking at maybe a couple licks to start you off. So something that I found really difficult about learning the minor pentatonic scale was actually learning how to be able to apply it correctly. Finding the key or the root note of the music I wanted to play over is really, really difficult when you first start playing. And it was really, really, really hit and miss for me at that time. Also, when you first start learning the pentatonic scale, you're just presented with all these notes and no real idea of how to put them together with any real meaning or anything that really satisfied me at the time. So something that we wanted to do was put together a two-chord sort of blues backing track and then give you just a handful of basic licks to be able to play over that, just to kind of start you off. But what we're going to do is the first lick is going to be just the basic lick itself. And then the second time round, I'm going to embellish it a little bit more for any of the more advanced players. Also, I've purposely made this that you can play both the chords and the licks at the same time. And really, when I started moving on to that aspect of my playing, it really helped me develop my pentatonic licks. And even just work on any real music you wanted to do, it's a great feeling to be able to kind of be the whole band at one time and play both chords and a melody on your guitar. It was really invaluable for me and kind of followed that, you know, Jimi Hendrix, Thomas Eirach, John Frusciante style of playing, which is the, you know, the people that really influenced me at that time. So let's get on with it. So for our two chord blues progression, we're going to be playing in A minor. And so you're going to be starting your first shape of the minor pentatonic here on the fifth fret of the sixth string, exactly like how Paul showed it to us. The first chord is going to be an A minor 7, like this. And the second chord is going to be a D9. The chord diagrams, the scale shape, and also the backing track are all going to be available in the description. So maybe take a while to just familiarize yourself with those and familiarize yourself with the chords, maybe, if you wanted to try and play along. The first lick I'm going to do is going to be really, really simple, just the basic lick itself. And then the second time, I'm going to embellish it a little bit more. Okay, let's go on with it. Okay, so let's break down each of the four basic licks. So the first one on the A minor 7 went like this. And that's simply the fifth fret on the G string to the seventh fret on the G string, and then up to the seventh fret on the D string with my third finger. So that's all with alternate picking. I will play it normally, and then I'll play a slow version. So it went like this. And slowed down. And again. So for the second lick over this D9 chord, I used a lick fairly similar to the first lick. So it's back here on the G string on the 5th and 7th fret. But instead of going up here to the D string on the 7th fret, I'm essentially repeating the first part of it. So I'm going 5-7, 5-7. And what I'm doing is I'm picking the 5th fret on the G string, and then I'm using my 3rd finger to hammer on to the 7th fret. So slowly like this. So I'm literally picking this first and then using my third finger to essentially hammer down on the string. And I'm doing that twice. So like this, slowly. And then picking again. And at full speed. And one more time. Then for the third lick on this A minor 7 again, I'm now down here on the B string, and I'm using the 5th, the 8th here with my little finger, and then going up here to the 7th fret on the G string. So I'm now moving with all alternate picking for this one. I'm going from the 5th to the 8th and then up to the 7th. So. And again. It's actually quite similar to the first lick in that I've now just moved it down to the B string. The good thing about these licks is that even with just small differences between them, they can have a lot of different effects. And like you'll see in the second round of the licks that I did, where I've kind of embellished them a little bit more, sometimes all I'm doing is changing the timing ever so slightly, or the technique that I'm using ever so slightly, and it's just changing that feeling. And that's the thing with the pentatonic scale, is that it is really the really small details that you can change. It's, you've got all these notes in front of you and you feel like you need to use them all, but actually, you know, breaking it down to 2, 3, or 4 notes and simply recycling them using different techniques and trying to get almost as much out of them as possible, you actually get more for your money in a way. Okay, so let's move to the last lick. So back on this D9 here. I use this kind of Joe Bonamassa type lick. But this time I'm up here on the D string, the 5th and 7th fret again. And all I'm doing is with alternate picking, going from the 5th to the 7th. And then down here to the G string on the 5th fret. So, and then back up to the D string, like we did almost with the first lick, with my 3rd finger on the 7th fret. So slowly like this. And again. And as with all these licks, again, you can keep embellishing them. Like I say, the kind of Joe Bonamassa-ish, I'm sure he probably found that somewhere else, is really getting this kind of like quarter note here on the G string as well. So you get this very kind of moany like sound. So again, that's bending it down almost out of tune. The more out of tune that bend is, the better. So when, I think maybe the only times we'll ever say bending out of tune is actually good.
I bend out of tune all the time. It's amazing.
So one more time. You may notice with some of the other notes as well that I'm adding a little bit of vibrato. So I'm literally using my wrist here as like a pivot, and just adding a little bit of vibrato to the notes. So essentially using my wrist here, like this is the pivot point, just moving it here with the note, just to add a little bit of feel to the notes.
Okay, so it's now that time we've all been waiting for, the dual note challenge. So hashtag two note challenge, check it out. So some of the best advice I ever got was from a very wise man, actually. He said to me, "Hey man, you play too many notes. What you should do is play less notes." And I'll tell you what, that really affected my life, actually. It's probably the best advice I ever had. From basically all of this time, I was just playing so many notes. I was just trying to fit in as much as I could. And then just that man just changed it all. So actually, this is the whole point of the two note challenge. This has affected us both very deeply, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's definitely, actually, when you first presented with the minor pentatonic scale, you know, there's so many notes and so many different fingerings to worry about. it's actually, to get something really musical, it's really good to restrict yourself and actually, like I say, you know, like we've said, go down to 2, 3, 4 notes, you know, and really try and use different techniques and emotions and timings and approach to just get the best out of them, get the most musical thing out of them. So hence why we're each going to choose 2 notes. We're going to use the same backing track, which is going to be in the description below, which is going to, again, in A minor. It's the same one we used for the licks. And literally, we're going to play over that and essentially try and get the most music we can get out of, we can squeeze out of 2 notes, using different techniques and stuff like that. So if we want you guys to send us your 2-note challenge, so the audio is in the link below. Send us your 2-note challenge, hashtag 2-note challenge.
Reply to this video.
Yep, and then you can do it on Twitter or whatever.
Fuzzbox.
Send that. They're pretty musical.
Instagram.
Yeah, I mean.
Wow. Good technology going on. I'll tell you what, here's my 2 notes, right?
You're in.
3rd string, 5th fret, and 7th fret. That's it.
He's in.
That's it, right? That's it.
Ready?
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, that's all right.
Okay. Ready?
Thank you very much.
So for my 2-note challenge, I am going to be choosing the B string, the 5th fret on the B string, and the 8th fret on the B string. These 2 notes here.
Dangerous move, I like it.
That's how I'm
feeling dangerous.
I'm quietly confident.
Oh, okay. Oh, you're quietly confident.
I'm quietly confident, oh. Yeah.
I'm feeling dangerous.
Soon to be amplified confidence.
Should we do this?
Let's do it.
All right.
So that's it from us for this episode. If you like what you saw, leave us a like. And if you want to follow us and know more, click subscribe. The next episode will be going up on our website. But we'll be leaving a little teaser here. It's going to be on the 2nd shape of the minor pentatonic scale. But we're going to be looking at some different techniques, some different approaches, some chords, maybe even some tapping. And just kind of trying to turn it on its head, really. So also send us your 2-note challenge, use the hashtag 2-note challenge. You can send it to us via Twitter. You can comment back to this video with a video response, and the winner of the 2-note challenge will win this practical poultry as, advertised in the intro, signed by the two of us, and we'll get that sent out to you guys. So use hashtag Two Note Challenge.
It's a great magazine.
It's actually brilliant. So that's it from us. And I think we're going to maybe even try and start a playthrough series where we might be covering maybe Sacred Shapes, seems like a popular one. So we might be covering that in the next couple of weeks too. So that's it from us. Thank you. Yeah.